Welcome to the CPU Galaxy channel. Yeah, and it's again time for a weird CRT video. If you saw already the other videos on my channel, you should know that I also like to have much fun with small CRTs and pocket TVs. Yeah, and today we will have a very close look on this special one. I'm talking about this nice Sinclair model TV80. Yeah, the Sinclair TV80, also known as the flat screen pocket TV, was a pocket television released by Sinclair Research in September 1983. It used a flat CRT with a side-mounted electron gun instead of a conventional CRT. Yeah, the picture was made to appear larger than it was by the use of a Fresnel lens, but it was a commercial failure and only 15,000 units were sold. So, this is at the end a quite rare piece, but at least we have two of them here available to mess around with them. And you know the rule 666? If it's possible, play Doom on it. Before we check the inside of this set, let's have a look at the outside. We have here an on-off switch with a volume regulator. Here the regulator for the tuning. On the side we have a check for an external power supply. And here a connector for a headset. On the top we have, of course, a common antenna. Unfortunately, we don't have any input for a video signal, so it will take quite an effort for us to feed this thing with the right signal. Yeah, then let's have a closer look on the inside and look at this interesting part. So, obviously, we have here this really special CRT. It's also made of glass and 1.5 centimeter thick. The very special part of it is the electron beam comes from the side and gets deflected on the phosphor coating here. Actually, this is not a magnetic deflection, this is called here electrostatic deflection. So inside here we can see those two plates, which are for the horizontal deflection. And on the back side here we can nicely see inside the tube here these two plates for the vertical deflection. Behind here we have some grids and here behind we have our filament. So very, very interesting. If you compare it to a conventional tube, we have of course the magnetic deflection, here the electron gun, which goes on the back side of the phosphor coating. So the light has to go through the phosphor coating to the front where you can see the image. Completely different here with this tube. The electron beam is coming here from the side, get deflected to the surface of the phosphor coating, and you can actually see through the electron beam on the surface of the phosphor to see your image. So very nice, you are looking through the electron beam to see your image. Very, very nice. Yeah, what else can we see here? Here we have some regulators for maintaining the image quality, sharpness, brightness, contrast and so on. On the side here we have a small speaker and here the circuitry which is creating the high voltage for our anode here. And I can tell you, I experienced it already, if this thing is applied and you touch it like that, this thing is going to bite you really hard. So if you want to learn more about the functional principle of this tube and this television set, just go to EEV blog. They've explained in a video nicely everything about this special tube. I will put a link below. Here, before we go on with our project, let's try to supply this set if we can get any image here on the screen. So we need here plus minus 6 volts. And before I switch on, let me dim the light a little bit that we can see something. So, and again, see, touching here, this is very dangerous. Don't touch any PCB of a CRT when you switch it on. So let's try. No, I forgot to switch on the power supply. So, yeah. And we have already the common noise picture of old analog TVs. So very nice. I'm pretty sure that we can play here Doom. Yeah, then let's check out the computer hardware I'm going to use here. Of course, for a special setup, we use something special. This is a single board computer made by Advantech. We got here a Pentium 1 266 MHz mobile processor directly soldered on the PCB. This card comes also up with a Chips and Technology video chip on it. On the side here, we can see our video connector, we got a LAN board also, a serial interface and a connector for our keyboard. On the back side, we can see here two slots for RAM and one is equipped with 64 megabytes of SD RAM. Also very nice, we got here a CF card reader included, so I put here already a CF card where Microsoft DOS is installed, as well as Doom, which we will need later on. Very nice. Yeah, for the sound card, I will go for the Creative CT1600, the Sound Blaster Pro 2. Yeah, and how can we combine those two cards now? Actually, for this, I will use this kind of ISA backplane, so we can put here the single board computer, as well as other cards you might need for your setup. Over here, we can just connect the standard 80 power supply to supply the single board computer and the Sound Blaster card. So you can supply basically all single board computers always through the ISA bus, so all needed voltages the single board computer can take over here. In this case, very nice, we got here a Molex connector where you just put your 5 and 12 volt connector to supply the board. That means you could use this board also standalone without any ISA backplanes. Yeah, what else do we need to convert our signals from VGA to the right signal for our mini CRT? First of all, we need to convert it from VGA to a video composite signal. So I'm using this small adapter for this purpose. But this is not enough yet, because we have here on this CRT just an antenna input. So we need to convert the video composite signal to an HF signal. So I will use a kind of modulator. This is also, I think, from an old camera, where we have then a video composite input. We need to supply this also, and here we get then a HF output. Yeah, let's see if this is going to work. In my previous CRT videos, I didn't use the audio also on the mini CRT, but in this project now, I would like to get the original audio from the sound card also through the modulator coming out directly of this CRT here. Yeah, nothing more to say right now, and I would say let's build up the setup. So then let's go for the first test run. Let's see, switching on. So, okay, this is running. Let me dim again a little bit the light. So, switch on the computer. So we got already the beep from the BIOS that it's booting. That's good. Let's try to get the signal. There is something, but I cannot see anything. Also, the image looks somehow weird now. Okay, so I cannot get the image now here. Strange. So I'm obviously tuned now, because we don't have the noise anymore, but I cannot get a proper picture. Yeah, after 1 hour playing around and trying my best, I found out that maybe this CRT television has also a problem. So I will try the second one. Thanks God we have two available. And I might also have a problem with my modulator here. So I will also try another one. But I have some solder work to do. And yeah, let's see. After a whole day of work, finally I think the setup should run now. I had some troubles to solve because it was not easy to convert all the signals from VGA to video composite and then from video composite with a modulator directly to feed the antenna of this TV set. The image I could get very quickly, but the problem was the audio. I wanted to have the audio from the sound card directly coming out also here from the speaker of this television set. And yeah, this old modulator, which I'm just misusing from a video recorder or so, was not handling the audio input properly. And I think there was something not well aligned anymore with the frequencies, so I had to set here a lot of things inside to get the audio also running here on this video set. At the end it was somehow walking in the dark with closed eyes to search something, because I don't have the proper equipment to measure these HF signals. So then let's start to supply the television set and the modulator. So, alright, so we get already here the flickering image on the screen and this noise, this typical noise from these old television sets. So then switch on the computer and let's wait if it's booting. Yeah, so I got now the beep from the BIOS, so the computer is booting. I set the auto exec button already, that it's booting automatically Doom. We can search here then nicely to tune here our set. So then let's search. It was here somewhere. I got it. How cool is that? We got it here. And actually with a quite nice image quality. How cool is that? And the audio is perfect. Great. This is so cool. Let's play something. I can hear already many of you writing or see the posts. Oh, this is pointless to play Doom on such a small old screen. No, it's not pointless, because as soon something makes fun, it's not pointless anymore. So, EDKFA, EDDQD, of course I'm going to cheat here, because I need a little bit a better bass to fight here on this small screen. Actually, the quality is not that bad. I can see something at least. Not even something, I can see more than something. This is cool. How cool is that? Doom. So I guess this small TV set was never expecting to work anyhow again, and playing Doom. How cool is that? Let's take another weapon. So from my point of view, this is very nice playable here. So nice to enjoy this after one day of struggling here. I'm so happy now that this is working. Oh my goodness, what a joy. I like it. Yeah, I really like it. So here another video shot where you can see the screen a little bit better. Yeah, the whole project turned out to become a little bit more complex than I thought, especially to get the audio running also on the TV set. those setups with HF modulators and signals are very sensitive of getting noise into your circuit, so it took me quite a while with shielded cables and short connections to get a proper image here. Nevertheless, I had a lot of fun playing around with this little TV and bringing it back to life. I hope you liked the video, and if so, please subscribe below and thumbs up. Thank you very much for watching, and see you next time.